Pro tip, don't stand all in the same place, especially if it's a choke point. Genius. Welcome everybody, I'm RC, and this is Spartan Ops Legendary Solo. It is of course a co-op mode, so doing it solo is stupid, and I'm doing it without deaths, which is the main point here. This is episode 2, Artifact, and this is chapter 4, Pelican Down on the Sniper Alley. Sniper Alley is one of the campaign mission based ones. This is from like the 5th mission, Reclaimer or something like that. AA guns in the area. I've forgotten. Apparently, Spartan Team Crimson, or Spartan Crimson, because we're always on our own for some reason, got shot down by some AA. So we're still on our way to wherever it is we're supposed to be. And on the way we're going to kill a load of enemies who are defending some AA guns. And we think, well, rather than going around them, let's just punch straight through the middle of them and take out the AA guns while we're doing it. So just hiding behind that sort of little piece of vegetation there. So I don't really want to engage that phantom. I can't do anything about it. I don't got big enough guns. There's actually a little group of sniper jackals that I was shooting at there. I don't know if you can see them very well. I think it's about 4 or 5. Right there. Oh, I got a headshot there. You have a huge range advantage on them. Despite them being snipers, they're not particularly good ones. And that is a rock. So, this map has an overabundance of infinite ammo dumps. I think it does. Most of the ones on this map do. But anyway, going to be taking this fairly slow. There's a lot of enemies. I actually kill, let me check, 105 enemies on this. So double the last mission. I got to do them all myself. You can't actually destroy any of the AA guns before you kill all the enemies. The buttons just will not activate. So there's not really any opportunity to speed run through this. There's one of the crates with the infinite ammo for UNSC weapons. Does most of the bullet weapons apart from snipers. And it also does the railgun as well, which I use in one of the later missions to great effect. Love it. One of the highlights of the series, that episode is. So, lots of drop pods, as you might expect. Of course, my loadout, the MR plasma pistol, pretty standard. Got my ammo buff as well. Practically don't play Spartan Ops without it. This area can be quite tricky because there's a bunch of enemies up on your left side and you're trying to go around this very tight corner. Gotta stick close to cover, be very swift to take them out. That's an invisible elite in that drop pod. Make sure you know he's coming. Took me by surprise a few times. I know he's somewhere there. There he is. Oh, the dreaded reload. Whoops. Apparently I'm too tall. Is that a leak gun? So, those snipers are one of the biggest threats. There's a first wave, and then you sort of get to the top of this ramp, and then there's another group of them that come in as well. And as you saw, they can actually take you out before you get there. These ones are better than the first group of snipers. They're a bit more aware. Also a turret. If I had some grenades, I could throw them at him, get him off it. Don't. So I'm gonna have to use something else. That is also one of the most ridiculous moves in the game because of that. Still getting shot at. Palmer calls Dalton and gives you a sniper rifle drops down behind you. You see it on my motion tracker and my HUD. You just gotta be really careful with this one. There's so many. I mean, they're nerfs from, let's say, Halo 2, but there's so many of them that they can still take you out pretty much instantly. Multiple people firing at you. Ow! Then you got that flinch, of course. It's always screwing you up. Second time. And one more there. Here's a sniper rifle. I didn't really use it. On co-op, this is way easy. Just four DMRs, just all going downrange. So I've gone up to there, close to the ramp, and then a bunch of enemies have spawned. Some of them can be quite aggressive. Didn't manage to run quite as quick as I meant to. You can, of course, just stay underneath that structure there, and you don't have to come back here at all. But I decided, since I have the sniper rifle, I'm going to use it to take out a few of the enemies just to soften them up. Give me a bit more breathing space. Surprisingly timid of these ones, actually. Screwing up some of my shots. Now I'm shooting nothing. So I'm just gonna cut my losses. Go with the combo instead. So, managed to whittle down the enemies on this side. This level, sorry. Just to this guy. Way easier. There's some more people upstairs. Good opportunity for jetpacking up and throwing a few grenades, maybe. And then we're done. Now we can activate the button. Oh, sorry. They've got to talk first. Never mind. There we go. And it dissolves! Or teleports, I don't even know what happened. There's the next one. Very close. You could theoretically run to it. Or you could have set yourself up right next to it. Again, the button doesn't work. I had some trouble taking out all of these enemies in such confined space without getting killed, so I decided not to try anything fancy on these guys. Could have done. Got killed by these guys a couple of times. Dual few rod gunners. Still be aggressive though. Use their boldness against them. A couple of grenades, plasma overcharge, a few DMR headshots. That, and that right there, that's why Halo's good. You're looking at it, and you think, are there any more guys? Like, is it clear? Can I just run up to it? Being cautious. Oh, cool, I can actually take over it. No. Nah, that's freaked me out. Screw that, man. Yikes. Didn't expect that to explode. I'm just gonna wait for it to leave, because it will do eventually. You've not really got access to anything big enough to take down its turret. It's got fewer guns, but shh, not gonna get close enough to that. So some of them will sort of one at a time come down, creep forward, but a lot of them here will just stay back. And this is what makes it sniper rally. Would have been nice if you had access to maybe a few more sniper rifles. If you'd started with one. had maybe like a super special crate at the Pelican crash site, something like that. That would have been good. Beam rifle's not too bad though. Just some of these little barriers on those walkways are a bit high. Another one over here. Sniper rifle this time. Don't know how it got there. Trying to take a grunt. You know, it gets pretty hard without aim assist from this range. Four shots, I believe, with the sniper rifle for a golden elite. There's two, three, four. There you go. Perfect. So there's the first group of enemy. And then you'll want to get close. There's come some hunters there that you'll try and figure out a way to try and take them out as well. I think there's another group. We'll come down in a phantom in just a minute.
Target destroyed, Commander.
Excellent. Dalton, the air corridor is open again.
Thanks, Commander.
Crimson, let's get you moving in Gargaren's direction.
More Covenant inbound, Crimson. Not that I want to belabor the obvious, mind you.
Miller, your attention to detail is one of the few things I truly like about you. Never stop.
Full Fuhrer gun in that crate. Thought, why not? Of course, I'm getting shot in the ass by the new group of Covenant coming down, though. Always some. This second group, and I think it's the last group. No, it's no way near the last group. Is much more aggressive than the first one. Just gonna get back some ammo. Again, really exploitable. Could die, get your ammo back that way. But again, that would defeat the point. Come on, come on, come on. Enemies don't pop as much as in previous games. Colors are much more dull. Makes sniping a little bit more tricky. Which is kind of weird when like multiplayer is still bright red versus bright blue. They make it harder for the campaign people, right? There we go. Knew it wasn't the last one. Typical. This is the part which gets tricky and a bit laborious if you're on your own. I mean, if you're, there's like four of you, just go in, plasma pistols, DMRs, go straight up those ramps, throw some grenades on where they're spawning in, and this one's over like really quickly. Under 10 minutes easy. One or two of them are aggressive. But it varies how aggressive they are. Some will come down to that ramp. Some will actually come almost all the way up to you. At least I've got a big mess of dots telling me where they are now. Man, that is a lot of dots. How many is that? 15, something like that. Ah, the standoff. I can't shoot them enough, and they won't come to me. Main problem I inflicted on myself here really was I picked up the Furod gun, and so if I'd just gone with another plasma pistol, managed to find another plasma pistol, that wouldn't have been a problem. But I don't want to drop the Furod gun because obviously it makes it much easier to kill the hunters. In theory, of course. The problem I experienced on previous attempts at this was that the hunters would get very aggressive once you'd killed all the enemies. All the other enemies, sorry. And it can make it sort of a little tenuous at best trying to get back to the Furod gun crate right at the end, over the heads of the hunters. Didn't want that to happen, but I ended up sort of overcompensating. So yeah, there's plasma pistols in there. Oh, got you eventually. Anyway, it's not a speedrun. Doesn't really matter, does it? Just trying to sort of shake them out of that place with that. Throw a little barrage that way, get them to move to left or right, maybe. Get out from behind that huge pillar. See, occasionally, one of them's aggressive. Your lack of foresight will be your downfall, Elite. And your craftiness will just make me end you with more prejudice. I always find it funny when they're just walking through this like huge cloud of green. Absolutely stopped in their tracks by the explosion. So I picked up the Furod gun for the hunters, and I'm using it on the elites because I've got nothing else. Because I don't want to drop the Furod gun and have it despawn when I'm actually trying to kill the hunters, and then I'll have to go Rambo on them. And so I shoot myself in the foot twice. Typical, innit? So what's that? Is that a hunter? No. There's a jackal. Now the hunters will die. Finally. Not, they can actually just move on to the next mission, Gagarin. Gagarin, Jesus. Their poor pronunciation is getting me now. But I'll complain about that next episode, don't worry. Well, that was a massive waste of ammo. Oh well, typical. What other options do I have? Are there any other weapons I could get? Last enemy, get killed by the last hunter. How embarrassing would that be? Having to do what I didn't want to do anyway. So you can see how scared I am, like trying to sprint around it. Come on, dude, that's pathetic. Oh my god, it's gonna hit me. There we go. All enemies dead. Woo! They're 20 minutes later. Episode over. So that was episode 2, Artifact. Chapter 4, Pelican Down on Sniper Rally. Done. Gotta wait for them to finish talking, but this little corridor is the ending bit. Fade down. Chat complete. Let's just see my time. 19 minutes, 3 seconds. Told you, 105 enemies. Have fun with it. Let me know how you get on, maybe. If you have a go. But anyway, I'll see you in the next episode. And that'll be Chapter 5, Gagarin. On the Refuge. So I'll see you then.